Okay, so I know that this is a good mark here. So now what I need to do is I need to mark these two identical. So this, you know, the front and the sides are mitered. Compound. This is just a straight 20 degree. This is 20 degrees here, but I had to do the compound miter on that. So let me go ahead and get a square and mark this right here, and that'll tell me where what I need to put up to that cut line there. So this is why I like to have that cut line, because now I want to cut to this mark. All I have to do is put that on that, you know, that kerf line that, you know, that's exactly where the blade is going to go. Clamp it in place and cut. Okay, I am one whisker long on this piece, so let me retrim it. Perfect. Okay, let me switch this to 90. I'll cut my two sides to length, since they're going to be 90s, to mate with this. And then I'm ready to start doing my joinery on here. So I'm finished with these miter cuts for a while, so I think I'm going to flip this over to this side. This one's only going to need 3. See the way I ganged up the holes here at the end? So this is going to be where it's going to get shifted and shifted until this gets too short, and then I pitch it and get another one. So I'll probably just go with this one here first, all the way out. Yeah, I'll go back one more. I don't even like getting close to that blade. Okay, since I've tuned my saw up, I can just set this right off the miter gauge. I can just set that square off the bar. So let me go do that. I'll clamp it in my bench over here and take care of that. Before, I was having to set it up off the thing because I think I had a little bit of rack in the saw. I mean, when I made my correction with the dial indicator, I mean, I was like a thousandths off when I adjusted the deck. But it was a little bit. Perfect. Okay, this one is already cut to length. So again, cut to a mark instead of cut to a stop block. Oh, it helped if I did it right. Can't improve on that. Okay, I'm done with this high fence. I don't need to use this anymore. So I'm actually gonna just cut this in half and then put it back on. Doesn't have to be that close. So you can see why I was good to drill those three holes here at the end, because I'm already gonna be, you know, kind of encroaching on that. I didn't realize I was gonna drop that little piece off the end. I was actually really glad it didn't kick on me here. But it's gonna be just fine. So this is gonna be a huge time saver, and it's gonna be more accurate because, you know, being here in Texas, the weather can change so much. I mean, it can just, humidity can come in, or it can get just bone desert dry. And so if you just have a piece of wood just kind of dangling out there, it's, you know, it tends to move around a lot. So I was kind of wasting a lot of time taking pieces off and resizing them. And like I said, this is pretty much what I have to have when I work. I want to see a cut line right there, you know, where I can just put something up to a mark and know exactly where the saw is going to cut the piece. And then I don't ever reach for the blade until it stops. And then this, just this easily now, this is a real revelation for me to, you know, say you change blades and so the cut line is going to be slightly different, or you do something, so just shift it over. So really simple, but really, really effective. And let me sight down that.
That's just as straight as can be.
Okay, just look how flat this stays. So here's my 24-inch Mitutoyo. I mean, that is just... what more can you ask for woodworking? You know, I was just showing this in a demo, but I don't like this half hole here at my cut line, so I'm just going to get rid of it. Probably put some marks on here so I can always remember which ones I've got the bolts in. Zero insert back in my zero space back in here. I've been tipping the blade over so much to the right, that's why I've got that one in there right now.